Hello everybody, welcome to my new video. We are in two leads, four stops. I'm gonna show their last, our last clan war battle. I'm gonna say a few words in Turkish. Arkadaşlar şimdi bu videomuz İngilizce olacaktır. Artık videolarımız biraz daha İngilizce ağırlıklı olacak çünkü yabancı arkadaşlarımızdan gelen istekler bu doğrultuda. Bir klanımız daha var, Avustralya klanı. Onların turnuva savaşlarını ve klan savaşlarını çekeceğiz arkadaşlar. Bu yüzden İngilizce ağırlıklı videolarımız artabilir. Tabii ki Türkçe videolarımız da yapacağız. Bu arada yine şöyle size göstereyim arkadaşlar. Eğer turnuva klanı olacaksanız, bakın, klan savaşlarından vazgeçmeniz gerekir. Yani bir ya da iki turnuvaya katıldığınızda klan savaşı yapabilirsiniz. O çok önemli değil. Ama 3'ten 4'ten fazla turnuvaya girdiğiniz zaman klan savaşı yürütemezsiniz arkadaşlar. Keza her zaman söylüyorum. Eğer bir klan olarak turnuvaya katılacaksanız en az 2 takımla çıkmaya çalışın. İkinci takım güçsüz olabilir. Önemli değil. Ama çıkın. Eğer çıkamayacak durumdaysanız birinci, yani tek turnuva klanı oynayan beşli oyuncuya da saygı gösterin, destek olun. Bu yüzden anlaşamayan klanlarımız var maalesef. Yani bu çok kötü bir şey. Bilmiyorum, hala bu turnuvanın değerlerini anlamış değiller. Şimdi bakıyoruz klan savaşına. Şu anki çekeceğimiz video 2 gün önce yapılmış klan savaşı. Ondan önceki de 9 gün önce arkadaşlar. Ekranda görüyorsunuz zaten. Onun videosu da, Phoenix Town ile yapılan savaşın videosu da zaten kanalımızda da var. Peki bu 7 günlük içerisinde iki boş, yani bu iki klan savaşı arası boşluğunda ne mi oldu? Tabii ki klanımız turnuvalarda savaştı. Arada bir gün beklenilen durumlar oldu. Hele ki biz zaten bekliyoruz. Şu an bir turnuva maçı var. Kadroda mesela ben yokum. Beklemek zorundayım. Yani çünkü kural bu şekilde. Yani bundan gocunmamalıyız. Ben turnuvada yokum diye hadi gidip de bir yerde klan savaşına gireyim muhabbeti yapmamıza hiç gerek yok. Çünkü turnuva oyuncusu olmak istiyorsanız ve turnuva klanı olmak istiyorsanız klan savaşlarında ya azalma olacak ya hiç girmeyeceksiniz. Her zaman söylediğim, büyük klanların savaş günlüğüne bakın ki savaş günlükleri hep açıktır. Klan savaşlarını görmeyeceksiniz. Bazen oyuncular başka yerde klan savaşına girebilir. Tanıklık olduğum şeyler de var. Ama bu sık olan bir şey değil. Artık videomuza İngilizce olarak devam edelim. Let's see speaking English. So let's look last clan war attacks. Check the war statistics. The two late four stop took 11 3 stars and enemy didn't 3 stars. So already they didn't use their attacks. For us it's easy clan war. Let's see number 1. Arcturix coming in with Yeti Bowler's attack. How did he start? At 9 o'clock, the one loon and one baby dragon and the queen again 9 o'clock, but upside. Let's say something. There is a 2 frame vacancy, that's why a queen will not like that, go out like that, because he will her direction will be like that, because the baby dragon cleaned that area. First of all, he take the enemy RC. There is a freeze on the Inferno. And CC coming out. The Ice Golem, Hellhunter and Archers. As I say, yes. There is a poison. And King and Sage Barracks drop at 2 o'clock. And they have Earthquakes. How he is use that. Okay, he uses, and the all Yetis and Bowlers coming at 11 o'clock. The king behind the wall like that. So all yetis and boulders will be entered on the center. Queen take the town hall. He uses the warden ability. There's a tornado in front of the town hall. There is a raid on the core. And RC coming out at 4 o'clock, like that 4 o'clock at bottom side. So I like this strategy. You know, this is different funnel. Queen start like that. And CH barracks and king clean the dead area. All yetis has to in the center. Later on, queen went to the outside and take the defenses. What was in CH barracks? It was one yetis and two witches. Not hogs or just yetis. I like that strategy. It's good. Congratulations, Atreus. By the way, he is Russian. And let's see second one. Number 4. Sky Scorpion in number 4. We're gonna see hybrid attacks. He has two Super Wall Breaker. And his queen level is 71. It's no problem. There's a raid on the queen. Queen walking at between 4 or 5 o'clock. There's a raid on the Inferno. Okay, what he thought? Queen has to in, and I don't know right or left. I mean right or left, I don't know. But queen didn't enter, and then he break the dead wall, and queen enter here. So he outscoop CC one hog rider. There's a rage. I didn't see. Right now he put the poison, he dropped the poison. There is a CH barracks at 11 o'clock and all hogs and miners coming at 1 o'clock. He uses the queen ability, he got the enemy queen. It's good attack. There is a heal. It was the first heal, and there is a raid on the army. The town hall is wake up. Queen see the town hall, and he take the town hall. She take the town hall. That's cool. Normally he wants to in like that. But he didn't success. He uses the second chance in here. And he got the what he wants. He funneled by CH barracks at 11 o'clock. You know, the queen take like that. And CH barracks take like that. And hogs and miners in easy. So congratulations. Let's see the third attacks. I'm gonna show 12, the warrior attack. Okay, he uses the hybrid army again. How did he enter? Okay, queen walking at 1 o'clock, the one baby dragon at 11 o'clock, and one baby more at 2 o'clock. He wants to in eagle area. Now we are waiting because right now we taking the eagle. The eagle is down. All scatter shots on the near the town hall. Maybe it will be risky. Will be traps behind the town hall. So maybe he wants to take town hall by queen. But super wall breaker break the wrong wall. The king coming at 9 o'clock with siege barracks. Queen break the wall. Okay. He uses the king ability and all hawks and miners coming upside. CH Barracks hawks join the army, will be joined. So if he hawks change the direction, he uses the warden ability, CC coming out. As I say, two ice golem and one witcher, one witch. Town hall is down. There is a freeze on the scatter shot. All miners downside. We are seeing so many wizards. He didn't die yet. There's a freeze on the multi. It was risky attack, but he succeeded to take 3 star. You know, he wants to break that wall by super wall breaker, but super wall breaker broke that wall. Congratulations, warrior. Let's see the last attack. Number 14. Okay. EG coming by Electro. E-drag. Okay. In this way, the war level is low. It's not important because he uses the air attack. First of all, King dropped the 4 o'clock. One ice golem at 11 o'clock. He break the wall, super wall breaker. One giant and queen will be in that area. Behind the ice golem, he uses the RC. He wants to take a multi. He uses the queen ability. King didn't die yet. Okay, RC take the dead area. Queen take the dead area. And whole E-Drax will be in like that. Actually, he so lucky, I guess, because CC didn't coming out. And CC will be not problem for him. There's a rage on the core for E-Drax. There's a freeze on the scatter shot. And behind the E-Drax, he dropped the blind throughout the town hall. He uses the Grand Warden ability. There's a rage on the E-Drax and the freeze. And last rage on the town hall. He got the town hall by Electro. By blind. So it was good attack. As I say, the walls level is not important because this was the air attack, but it's good strategy. And this was the last attack for this video. I hope you enjoyed, guys. See you next video. Thanks for watching me. Take care of yourself. Goodbye.